Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a full meal, and our entree is going to be called cheese and onion stuffed hamburgers. So I think that's pretty descriptive. So let's go ahead and make our hamburgers. First, I'm just going to show you that I'm making the patties in a certain way, and then we'll talk about the seasonings and what we're going to add and how they're going to get grilled and so on later on. But I did have right here 1 pound of lean ground beef, and I took a knife, and you can see some's missing because I've been working on it. I cut it into quarters. This is a quarter, so that would be a quarter pounder. This is a quarter, that'd be a quarter pounder, and then I took some out here. So in taking out about the same amount over here, I'm going to actually have a top and a bottom to an individual burger. We will be eventually, look over here, stacking a couple of burgers together, and they're going to be stuffed with some neat things like cheese and onions, and then we'll put those edges together and grill it all up. It's going to be a great tasting hamburger. So what I need to do is to take what I've decided on as the right amount and get it into a thin circle like that. You don't want it too thick because we're putting two of them together. If you have a hamburger press like this, it'd be nice to use it. Maybe go ahead and start to make that circle and then drop that down into your hamburger press, and that allows you, this part's supposed to go in first, that allows you to just press, and if you will press, it will come out with a nice circle. Now that circle for me is not big enough, but it helps to get started. If you don't have one of these, don't go out and buy one, definitely. It's not worth it, but it gives you a nice circular burger to work from, and then I'm just flattening that out like I did the other two. So let me get these ready, and then I'm going to come back and season them up. I'm just making two of these hamburgers right now, so I've got the patties made out, and they could use being a little bit bigger. It just depends on what size you want to do and what kind of buns you've got. But you're going to need some salt, and in this case I think I'm just going to use some meat tenderizer and make it nice and tender, as well as getting that salty taste. This meat tenderizer has no MSG. It's not unhealthy in any way, so don't worry about that. I like to use seasoned pepper to give it a little spice there. So just sprinkle a little. And this will be the inside, actually. What you're seeing in both cases will be inside. So we'll season the outside later on. What I'm going to do is take a piece of Deluxe American cheese. You can substitute any sliced cheese, about this kind of slice. And I have cut it into 4 squares, each one of those slices. I don't really need all of that for what I'm doing. But what I want to do is in the center here, where it won't go all the way out to the edges, I'm going to put 1 square of cheese. And then I have some onions that I have sauteed. This is the kind of onion, it's just a white onion. And I've used olive oil, 1 tablespoon, and gotten these nice and clear. They're beginning to brown, that's when you want to take them off. And we want this to have a nice onion flavor, so we'll put a little bit there. And let's see if we can put 2 of these on. If it doesn't work very well, then we'll just come back to 1. And a little more, because we want to take advantage of this idea of stuffing the hamburger the best we can, and the more we can get stuffed in there, the better off we'll be. So now I flip this in this direction because we put the seasoning there, remember, and then I want to crimp the edges together. So I'll go all around and do that, and then I will flatten it out, and then I'm going to go over the top with the meat tenderizer and also the seasoned pepper again. Then this will go out to the grill outside and come back a luscious hamburger that is stuffed with cheese and onion. I want to show you the burgers before they go out to the grill. They're all assembled, and I have gone around and crimped the edges together. Now, if some of the cheese should start melting and streaming to the outside, that's nothing to worry about. You might lose some of the cheese stuffing. That's not a big deal. It still will have plenty of flavor. You can see from the top there's some of that seasoned pepper, and also you can see that these are mounded up because they are fairly large, but I have some large buns to use with them. So let's get started grilling. Here are our two stuffed hamburgers, or cheeseburgers, I guess, since they're stuffed with cheese and onion, straight from the grill, and we're getting ready to put all of our foods together and make this wonderful meal. I want you to see what this looks like inside, and normally I wouldn't cut this at this point, but just for purposes of demonstration, I'm going to show you that it is stuffed and that you'll enjoy biting into something that looks like this. If I can get that open, can you see inside there? Looks pretty good, doesn't it? Because it has some onions. It had like two layers of onions and two layers of cheese. And it had the seasoned pepper and some meat tenderizer to spice it up. I think you're gonna like that. Let me show you my full meal that we've put together. Starting with a bun for the hamburger. I've chosen a nice Kaiser roll that has some good crusty wheat bran on top of it. And so I've already put my hamburger on there. And remember, this is that cheese and onion stuffed burger. So inside it, when I bite into it, I'll get that squishy cheese and onion flavor. And right here we have our broiled pearl onions. So that's just a nice little garnish and also tastes good and goes with the flavors that we have there. And then we have lettuce and tomato, and I've already taken care of mine. I like mayonnaise on my hamburgers usually, so I'll spread that out later. And then we have our corn on the cob. It's steaming hot, and I don't know if you can see it. I'll just take a fairly small piece. There aren't any really small ones. I'll just pick that up. It's kind of hot. And for that corn on the cob, I have some pure butter here. Just take some on my plate. I like for it to be at the edge and let it melt right onto that. And then I like salt on it, a little bit of salt. We'll just get that as we go. And then to finish up my meal, I'm gonna have a Coke with it. And then the fruit salad I'll come back for later, and it will be served in a little berry bowl. And that's our nice summertime salad, which has peaches and blackberries and bananas. And then there's gonna be a tart sauce because of the lemon juice and Splenda that we put. And over here I have some cupcakes that I made yesterday. These are the carrot brand cupcakes that are really healthy. And I don't know if I'll get to those or even if I'll get to the fruit salad because this is a big lunch for us. But anyway, I thought you might be interested in what we were having for lunch today.